Hi everyone, welcome back to Operations Research. So this is our second course. We want to talk about algorithms. And today we're going to talk about the simplex method. Okay, so let's take a look. So the thing is that we now want to study how to solve a linear program. So we don't want to just be able to formulate a linear program. We want to be able to know how to solve it. Okay, obviously, eventually we will learn how to do this in computers. We will write computer algorithms, okay? But as a mathematics course, in some sense, we teach you the basic fundamental ideas. We teach you the principles. The algorithm that we will introduce is the simplex method. This is the method developed by George Danzig, we mentioned in the past, in 1947. And I should say this is published in 1947, all right? And this basically opened the whole field of operations research. In the past, there are still a lot of people doing research in operations research, have a lot of important works, but the development and the publish of the announcement of the simplex method really make everybody knows this is important. Because there comes a lot of applications of OR, of linear programming. So it is implemented in most of the commercial LP solvers. It is because that we have the simplex method, so that since 1947, people in practice know how to solve real operations research problems. Okay, it's very efficient for almost all the practical linear programs and it has very simple ideas. So that's why in most of the OR courses, we still start from simplex method when we want to talk about algorithms. So the method is clever, I would say. It is in general effective, but it is do that in an indirect manners. So we know there are all kinds of different linear programs, okay? You have unbounded programs, infeasible programs, or finitely optimal programs. Also, you know, given a finitely optimal linear programs, you may have greater than or equal to constraint, less than or equal to constraint, non-negative variables, non-negative variables, and so on. So the first thing to do is that we will first show that all the linear programs is equivalent to one thing called the standard form program. So given any linear program, we're going to convert it to something we call standard form linear program. And then we will use our simplex method to solve it. Once we are able to develop a method to solve the standard form programs, we are able to solve any linear program. So that's the idea, and later we will show how that works. So this lecture will be full of algebra and the theorems. I hope we are all get ready to do all the things. So this is somewhat difficult, more difficult than those formulating exercises. Okay, now we really need to know algebra, some part of linear algebra. And there are mathematical theorems that we may need to go to details. But anyway, once we get across this, we will be able to really know that, oh, okay, so any linear programs can be solved, all right? And that's going to also be a very important foundation for us to understand many other things that we will talk about in later lectures, okay? So this lecture would be one of the most important lectures in the whole series. So I hope we will all get something from it.